something I want to review, the Crawford fight. You know, when I do douchebaggery, you know, I could see how the people that don't know me, I can come across as a douchebag or an asshole, okay, like gloating and shit like that. I'm not doing that, like, for you guys. I'm being a douchebag on purpose towards dudes like Thunderdome and PeePee and them, because, you know, I know they're watching. That's why I'm being a douchebag, if I'm, like, gloating and shit. Other guys just brush it off. I wouldn't even be doing that unless, you know, I know it pisses those dudes off, so that's why I do it. So I missed a fight last night. I do a lot of traveling, and wherever I am, I always look for, hey, you know, what's going on tonight? Is there pro boxing anywhere? And last night, the show box was Delvin Rodriguez, so, you know, I like going to fights. I didn't put in for credentials. You know, I'm pretty much retired from that unless it's a fight I really want to go to and I can't get tickets. I'll put in for credentials. But, so yeah, I wanted to go down and check it out last night, and I did. Thunderdome, remember how you said something about connections, having connections? Well, what do we have here? There's the box office. Look what's waiting for me. Mr. Tito Garcia. Let's see what's in here. Huh, a couple tickets. Row 7, section 7, row J. That's right ringside on the floor, row J. That's comped for free. Huh, interesting yet peculiar. Those are $150 seats, my friend. And, you know, you might say, like, oh, whoops, that's not a big fight or nothing. Oh, well, dude, I found myself in Connecticut, and I'm like, shit, is any pro boxing going on tonight? Saw it, picked up the phone, made a couple phone calls, and I'm in, dude. You see, that just proves that some people read the book, some people write it. Yeah, that's right. So, I just watched the Crawford fight this morning. I made my prediction yesterday. It went exactly how I said it was going to go. And I don't usually say this. I'm saying this for like the Thunderdome precisest case. If you go to my page, I said, you know, the early rounds will be even. And the mid rounds, Crawford's going to start pulling away. And then he's just going to dominate. And dominate he did. Absolutely dominated. I was surprised. You know, the one thing I can gauge a little bit, but I can't gauge that. I'd like to pinpoint it down, but I really can't yet. Was that how great Bud Crawford was, or was Postol overrated? You know, it's a little bit of both, but, you know, I don't know. Was that win just a great Crawford or, you know, shitty Postol? A little bit of both. I still think Postol's good. Like I said before, I've only seen four of his fights, five now, but that's a good enough gauge, you know. I was shocked that people said this was a 50-50 fight. Just, it shocked me. You know, I thought this was going to be a blowout the whole way. And that's not saying that Postol's not good. He is, okay? You know, he's very good. But like I said, if you want to just go watch my, you know, he's just a one-trick pony. I think Crawford had the edge in every department except for maybe the jab because, you know, he's got a longer reach and shit. Maybe the jab, but Terrence Crawford has a great jab. So, yeah, the fight went exactly like I said. I thought it was going to be a later round knockout, but it wasn't. You know, I'm a guy that will admit when I'm wrong. Up until, like, about last year, I started seeing the tides turn. Because I always thought Freddie Roach was good, you know, one of the best trainers in the game and shit. And I used to argue with, you know, the black guys a lot about Roach and shit. And, yeah, he's a fraud, man. I'm not saying he's a garbage trainer or anything. You know, he's kind of a piece of shit because he's out for number one always, you know. Roach is out for number one, period. He don't give a fuck about his fighters. But, I mean, once again, we see a Freddie Roach fighter that just cannot cut off the ring once again, you know. It's funny. He said he bet a bunch of money on fucking Postol last night. He said he was going to win 10 grand and he lost. But, yeah, Roach really is the joke coach Roach. I mean, I'm not saying he's a terrible coach, but the way he touts himself and, you know, HBO touts him and all that shit. He's nowhere near fucking just this legend at all. And once again, last night he was a fucking joke. But, yeah, Terrence Crawford shined. What did you want me to say? I just saw some just total. Well, let me get to this. You know, all these dudes are talking about, you know, I'm all about, you know, American pride, nation pride. So is everybody else except for these one group of dudes. And I think it's good for the sport. I always have said, always, that Gennady Golovkin's great and Sergey Kovalev's great. I've never wavered from that. These guys just think I do. I've never wavered from that. And I think that, you know, that kind of shit's good for the sport. It's great, you know, enemy, villain, all that shit. It's great for the sport. I just don't like their fans and going overboard. But, you know, all these dudes are talking about Eastern Europeans taking over, Eastern Europeans taking over. Well, last night was one of the very rare times where we're going to see the number one and number two guy in a weight class go at each other. And one's a fucking Eastern European and with the Eastern European style, and one's an American. And proved yet again that the fucking American style just absolutely dominated him, dude. Just dominated him. It just made him look foolish, you know? And we'll see what happens in the Ward fight, because that's another situation that's going to be very rare, too, where we see a number one or number two. But it just, you know, how could you guys possibly listen to, I listened to PeePee. How could you possibly listen to this dude? I mean, it's ridiculous. The fucking, the breakdown he gave. It was totally, and I get it, man. Everyone gives wrong breakdowns. I totally get that. But what he was saying beforehand, how, like, Postol has the advantage of this department. Postol has, and like, no, he doesn't. What the fuck are you talking about, dude? I mean, if you guys are really don't know that much about boxing and you're listening to this guy, he's poisoning your mind with bullshit. Really. You know, and then you got guys like Thunderdome, you know. Oh, this is a true 50-50 fight. True 50-50 fight. It's like, dude, no, it wasn't. What are you stupid? And he said, yeah. You notice how Thunderdome doesn't do prediction videos? Very, very rarely. And when he does, he'll brag about it. He'll do a prediction video. He doesn't do 50-50 fights. And he says it's a 50-50 fight. He doesn't do those kind of videos. And, like, he's still living on his Canelo over Khan prediction. It's like, dude, he always talks about it. It's like, dude, that was a fucking easy fight to call. I don't even do predictions on those. I mean, my predictions speak for themselves. I'm one of, if not the best predictor in the YTBC. One of, if not the best track records in the whole YTBC. Period. You know, a lot of it's luck and a lot of it's skill. A lot of it's, you know, knowing about the sweet science and how to break it down. So anyways, Thunderdome blows smoke up everybody's ass. Well, I bet on Postol. And let me tell you something, man. I've been around for a long, long time, okay? And I can tell you this. No. Zero street bookies take action on boxing. They just don't do it. He's lying when he says he bets on all those. They don't take action. Unless they got a guy saying, hey, you taking action on the fight tonight, and they got another guy, and they can put them together. There's no VIG for them. So they don't do it, okay? You know? I've dealt with bookies my whole life. They just don't do it. This dude's full of shit. And he also said, well, I took Postol because it was 6-1 odds, okay? Well, he's busted, okay? Because, yeah, Crawford was the 6-1 favorite. That means minus 600. But when you bet the other way in boxing, it doesn't mean you get plus 600. You know, Postol was like, you know, plus 375 or plus 400. The odds don't match either way. So he's busted lying right there. He did not bet on that fight last night, you know. And then this morning, he's going to come back and say, oh, yeah, well, at the last minute, I bet on Crawford, too. I hedged my bet. Dude, do you even know what hedging your bet means? You bet on one guy, and then at the last minute, you bet on the other to hedge your bet? That's a loser no matter what. Hedging your bet doesn't mean that. Hedging your bet is guaranteeing yourself money. Like, for example, if you do, say, a three-team parlay, okay? A three-team parlay pays 5-1. So if you bet, we'll keep it easy. If you bet $20, okay, on a three-team parlay, and two of the teams at 1 o'clock football have played and they both won, you have to hit all three teams. And the final game is San Francisco, New England, and you got New England, okay? So if New England wins, you're going to win $100, okay? Because you already got the first two in the bank. Well, if you want to guarantee yourself some money, you hedge your bet. And you bet 50 on the Niners, okay? So if New England wins, you're still going to win 50 bucks because you win the 100, but you lose 50 on the Niners, okay? If the Niners win, you're going to win 30 bucks because you lose the $20 on the three-team parlay, and you bet 50 and you win 30. That's what hedging your bet is. Hedging your bet isn't betting on one guy and then betting on the other. That's ridiculous, dude. Like, what the fuck? That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard in my life, especially in boxing. That means you're going to lose more. I mean, what a joke. Yeah, well, you know, at the last minute, I took Crawford, I bet on him too. I bet on Postol the next day. Well, by the way, I bet on Crawford. Get the fuck out of here, dude. What a joke. So let's hear from PeePee.
That's going to spell trouble for Crawford, I believe. So obviously, this is a 50-50 fight. I'm not counting out Crawford. I'm not
going to give Postol credit. It was never a 50-50 fight. Who the fuck ever said this was a 50-50 fight? And you notice how these dudes always do this when they're making prediction videos. Always. They're like, well, if it goes to the cards, I could see my guy getting robbed. Every single fucking time they could see their guy getting robbed. What a joke.
I think he's a very good fighter, very talented fighter, very promising fighter. But it's just that in this fight, I think the physical advantages and the skill advantages for Postol are just going to be too much for Crawford.
What the hell are you talking about, dude? The only advantage that's you could even argue is Postol may have had a better jab. And I don't even think so. I just think because it's longer and shit. That's it. And maybe more discipline. That's it. I mean, it's plain as day. Anybody could see that. Those are the only advantages that you could even argue that he has. Physical and skill? Are you kidding me? Of course it's Crawford.
Along with, you know, experience, having fought the better opponent and having the better corner. I think Postol...
Better corner? Yeah. Great game plan there, Roach, last night. Oh yeah, way to cut off the ring, too. What a joke.
Takes this fight. Although, if it's anything close, like if it's 7-5 Postol and not 8-4, 9-3, I just can't see him getting up until this point. Postol will always outwork Crawford, no matter what.
What are you talking about, dude? Did you even watch the Matisse fight? Dude, Roach is begging him to let go. The guy doesn't outwork anyone.
He has the better defense. He keeps his chin tucked better. He protects his chin better. His hands.
Better defense? Dude, Crawford gets hit 7 times per round. That's one of the best in boxing. What? Crawford's opponent connect percentage is the 2nd best in all of boxing, all of weight classes. What the fuck are you talking about? He's one of the best defensive fighters in the game. Dude.
He's up better. He has the physical advantages. He's just as fast. He hits just as hard. And when it comes to that, the guy that throws more punches has the advantage. So Crawford's going to have to catch him with something.
He's just as fast. He hits just as hard. And Crawford's going to have to catch him with something to win? Dude, reverse the roles on what you're saying. And you're absolutely correct. But just put Postol where you're saying Crawford. You could not be more wrong. And this is in hindsight. Before the fight, you could not be more wrong. Are you kidding me? I got a buddy named Roger, man, and he said, you don't know shit about boxing, PPN Thunderdome. You know, I roll solo, but I let anybody on Team Tito that wants to get down for the cause, they can get behind me, they can be on Team Tito. And, you know, if you listen closely right here, I say, yo, I'm on the money team. And my buddy Roger says, well, then I'm on Team Tito. So, all right, man, you guys are a couple buffoons.
Tonight in Vegas. What's that? 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 What's that?